measurement of frequency, guide wavelength, VSWR, power and attenuation in microwave test bench using klystron source. This is your basic setup. From left side, klystron power supply, klystron mount, klystron tube, isolator, attenuator, frequency meter, slotted section with tunable probe, and last detector mount. After that, I am using CRO and VSWR meter for measuring end. So first, you please turn on the fan, cooling fan. Cooling fan is there, one small fan. So you turn on the fan for cooling the klystron tube. This is klystron power supply. This is klystron mount, klystron tube, cooling fan, isolator, variable attenuator, direct reading frequency meter, slotted section, tunable probe, VSWR meter, CRO. This is your setup. Please turn on the fan for cooling klystron tube. Then CRO is already on. There is no waveform because klystron power supply is not turned on. So now you keep HT off, beam at minimum, rippler at maximum, remaining all at center, meter selector keep at current, modulation select AM modulation. Okay. Please turn on the fan. Next, you turn on the power supply. No beam, no rippler. Key voltage 0, current also 0, because we are not turned on HT. If HT is in off condition, no voltages are coming. So now I will turn on HT. See, beam is 189 and beam current slowly it will increase. It is already turned on, so it will increase slowly. It will start from 0.1, 0.2 milliamps, 1 milliamps, 2 milliamps, like that. It is 7.7 milliamps it's showing. So it will slowly it will increases. And next, you observe the CRO. I will tune rippler voltage here. I will tune this rippler voltage. What happens, you observe there. Now rippler is 275. Slowly I will reduce from 272. See, I got waveform reduced. This is one mode, this is another mode. I am reducing rippler. This is another one mode. So many modes are coming, 4 modes, 6 modes, like that. But you keep any one mode, any one suitable. See, this is proper wave. Don't keep like this. Okay. See, this is not proper. So keep like this, proper square wave. I should get proper waveform. Okay, and you please tune this to 1 kilohertz exactly. Now I am connected to VSWR meter and I have to set 1 kilohertz. When I am using VSWR meter, I have to set this to 1 kilohertz. This is AM frequency knob, amplitude knob. This is frequency knob. This is FM frequency knob, FM amplitude knob. So in this AM, you vary this knob frequency, and what happens, observe there on VSWR meter. See, I am now varying the frequency. So needle is increasing. So I am still varying the frequency, it decreases. So where I get the maximum, this is the maximum. So stop there. I varied AM frequency and I got the maximum power. You have to stop there. That is 1 kilowatts. This is your klystron mount. Tube is inserted here. All the supply voltages coming from this octal connector, it is connected to klystron mount and tube is connected there. Next, this is isolator, only one direction. In this direction it will pass the signal and return any reflection is there. There is a 20 dB attenuation for reflected signal, because this is a source, source should not get the reflected wave. So they are using one attenuator. Next, this is isolator. Next, attenuator is there. This attenuator, we are varying the, using screw gauge, we are varying this. So what happens inside? I have one open module. This is attenuator. So see, this is a absorption material. When it is inserted into the waveguide, there is a absorption of the signal. See, I will just press, see what happens. So when this is inside the waveguide, it will absorb the RF signal strength. So for the next stage, signal strength will be reduced. When we remove, again signal will passes to the next stages. So we can, it is a variable attenuator, so means we can vary the attenuation level from maximum 20 dB, 0 to 20 dB, variable. I can attenuate 5 dB, 10 dB, 15 dB, anything. And next is frequency meter. This frequency meter, I am going closer. So this is your frequency meter, it is like this variable. So when I got dip on a CRO, I will show that. Before that, how to read this frequency meter? See, this is a frequency window, these two lines are there, no? This is window, frequency window. Within the window, which reading is coincided with this vertical line? Inside the frequency window, coincided with this vertical line is 9.72. See, now the reading is, now it is exactly 9.72. Suppose it, if it is here 9.7, suppose for example 9.68, 9.66. So within the frequency window, which reading is coincided to this vertical line is our frequency, our readout. So I will show that on CRO where I get the dip also. Slowly rotate this and observe on CRO. Waveform is there. I have to get a dip. Slowly vary this. See, dip is here. See, this is a dip. At the dip time, you note down the frequency. What is the frequency? Just say it is 9.7, in between 9.7, 9.72. It is 9.7, something is there here. Within the window it is 9.7. Clear? 9.7 gigahertz. This is your slotted section. This is your movable carriage. Slotted section, movable carriage. Sk scale is here, and this is your tunable probe I can insert. For other experiments, you remove this. Only finding lambda g and finding VSWR, VSWR have to use tunable probe. Otherwise, you have to remove and keep it away. No need. Okay. Then this is a detector, crystal detector. Oh, there is one microwave diode. This is also, see, I have one more piece. This crystal detector, inside there is a microwave diode. That is, diode symbol is there, na? That is microwave diode. In some time there is no diode, they are using this detector, no use. With the diode only it will detect the signal. So after detection, that is message signal only, there is no RF signal. After this, there is a message signal, no RF signal, no gigahertz, only low frequency. That's what it is visible on CRO, or we can measure from VSWR meter. Otherwise we have to use power meters. There it is directly read the RF power. Now on CRO it is visible only low frequency in some kilohertz. In VSWR meter also it is only able to read 1 kilohertz plus or minus 50 hertz. We are not read any gigahertz on CRO, because our CRO itself 30 megahertz, or DSO some 100 megahertz. So we are not able to see RF frequency on CRO. So now we calculate the power. So just note down the voltage. I will set it to 200 volts. What's the current? 9.5 milliamps. 200 volts into 9.5 milliamps, that is your power. What power is drawing by your klystron tube? And then you observe the recovered power also in milliwatts, some dBs it is, it will show you. How many dBs I will tell you. It is 20 dB. Add this with this 20, 21, 22, 23, minus 23 dB, 0 to 10 dB red scale. Okay, you have to always, whenever reading the power, you take this where it is 20, 30, whatever. Now it is in 20, and add this 3 dB. 23, minus 23 dB power I am receiving. Just you note down all these readings, beam voltage, beam current, rippler, all 16, 1 to 16. Now we are going to do attenuation. This is attenuation tabular column. Start from 10 mm up to 0, 1 mm resolution. Note down the output power in VSWR meter. So see, it is on CRO now. So just I am rotating this, what happens, observe on CRO. Clockwise I am rotating. Power is reducing, see, decreasing, correct? So that you have to do by 1 mm completely reduced. Then you have to increase, it is there. So take for 1 mm, 1 mm, 2 mm, 3 mm. Now I am releasing, I am getting maximum. So, see, okay. So for this experiment, we have to connect it to VSWR meter. So now I am arranged very close to you. So here is the 10 mm. I say this zero, now it is in 10 mm. So reading, I will set it to next range, go to next range, I will bring it to zero. Okay, so now 30 and 0, I can vary by gain and coarse and fine. Minus 30 dB at 10 mm, I will note down the readings. Minus 10 dB at 10 mm, I will rotate this. One rotation is 0.5 mm, for two rotations it is 1 mm, pitch is 0.5 mm. So now it is 9 mm. Also it is 0 dB, little bit there only, 1, 2 rotations. Now it is reduced for 10 mm, also 30, 9 mm, also 30 I am getting. Now it is 8 mm, I am getting 30.5, minus 30.5, here it is 30, it is 0.5, have to add. And again next reading, two rotations, it is 7 mm, 30.8, here it is 0.8, here it is 30, 30.8, next two rotations, 1, 2, this 31.4, here it is 1.4, next two rotations, it is 6 mm or 5 mm, 3, here 30, minus 33, four mm, here it is 5 dB, here it is 30, 35, minus 35 dB. Next 3 mm, it is almost all very close, I cannot able to read it. What I will do, I will do minus 5 and next range. Then whatever the reading I am getting, I will make it minus 5. 40 plus 5.5, here it is 5.5, here it is 40. 45.5 minus 5 means 40.5. My reading is 40 dB minus 40.5 dB. Next I will do 40.5 minus 40.5 dB reading. So next I will come to normal. Next reading, two rotations, 1, 2, 2 rotations, 0 is here, 1, 0, second time 0 means 2. Here it is 40, here it is 5, 6 dB, 40, minus 46 dB. Next 0, 0, two times this out of range, go to next range. It is here it is 50, here it is 53 dB, minus 53. And the last reading, let me note down complete. It is, go to next range, here it is 60, here it is 0, 60 dB, minus 60, or in the previous it is 50, here it is 10, 60. For 0 dB, 0 mm, minus 60 dB. So my graph, my reading is like this. So I will plot this on graph, then you will observe. This is your graph for attenuation. Now we are finding lambda g. For that you have to use slotted section and tunable probe, connect it to CRO. Tight this, so now it is not moving. So see, on the CRO I am moving the slotted section probe carriage, so I am getting minima maxima. So I am getting minimas and maximas. So I have to find lambda g by two methods, two minima methods or two maxima methods. So you keep at any one maxima. See, this is one maxima, and note down the distance which is coincided to this zero. See, scale is visible. So for this zero line, which 12.6 is coincided with this zero, or you want to subdivision, you want to 0.01 accuracy, then go for next subdivisions. So just follow the vernier caliper you are using now, that procedure. So 12.6, note down it as a D1. Next, go to minima on CRO. See, we are at maxima, go to minima. Okay, next again come to continue to get the maxima. So this is maxima. So now also you note down the distance, read it as a D2, 10.3 and 12.6, you take a difference of it. So 12.6 minus 10.3, you will get 2.3 centimeters. 12.6 minus 10.3, you will get 2.3, multiply by 2. When you multiply by 2, you will get lambda g, then it will be 4.6 centimeters. When you are finding lambda, to find lambda c, just take any waveguide, all are same thing, and note down the distance, inner dimension, 2.3 centimeters. This only inner dimension, from the here to here, it is 2.3 centimeters. Okay. We will find VSWR for this load. This is crystal detector. I am finding the VSWR of this crystal detector. I have to use slotted section and tunable probe. The tunable probe output is connected to CRO. So this is Vmax. Please note down. This is Vmax. How much? Here it is 10 millivolt. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4.8 into 10 millivolts. Then I have to find Vmin. Rotate this slotted section to get the Vmin. See, this is a Vmin. And just note down, it is 1.4 box into 10 millivolts. 1.4 into 10. So that is 14 millivolts. Vmax is 48 millivolts, Vmin is 14 millivolts. Then your VSWR is Vmax by Vmin. So VSWR is equal to square root of Vmax by Vmin, because whatever we are seeing on CRO, it is doubled, squared, power only, not voltage. So we have to remove square. Then I will get VSWR is equal to 1.85, no units. So we will check the same thing on VSWR meter also. What is the VSWR we are getting? We will observe it. So first, here only it is clearly visible. On CRO itself, you set the maximum, V maximum. It is easy. Then after setting the V max, then you remove this probe and connect it to VSWR meter. So after connecting to VSWR meter, the needle is out of range. So you please select. So it is come to within the scale. Then you have to set to here SWR 1 is there, na? You have to set the needle to 1 using range DB now or these two fine and coarse. Okay. So I will vary this. Oh, sorry. Set this to, it is not possible with this, then I will go to next range, set it to SWR 1, it is exactly at 1, for the maximum condition we set to SWR 1. After this, here we have to move towards load, this is the load, we have to move this towards load. I am moving towards load. When needle reflects back, so stop there. This is around 2.2, 2.3 VSWR we are getting in meter. 2.3 through CRO we got 1.85. It is around 2. Both are approximately 2. This is how we can find the VSWR using CRO or VSWR meter. Following readings are noted down 1 to 16 and attenuation and calculating lambda naught and frequency. Lambda naught and frequency we are getting 9.22 gigahertz by calculating, and direct reading frequency meter we got 9.7 and calculated 9.2. it's almost all very close, no problem. And VSWR we got using a meter 2.3 and calculating 1.85. this we have to take a square root. Okay, here not mentioned, you have to take square root. Please contact us for demo, quotations, service, projects, internship for students.